All right, ladies and gentlemen, y'all already know what time it is, man. If you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content, and let's get right into it for each and every one of my gym stars. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy, Jay-Z, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BKA the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video. Y'all already know what time it is, man. Listen to me and listen to me good. I've realized something about myself. We're all flawed. We all have issues. We all got some things that we got to get over. My biggest thing is I am King Petty. I'm probably the pettiest person on the planet, man. I don't think it's too many people more petty than I am. And because of that, what I end up doing is I end up going back and forth with people in the comments that don't deserve any of my time. It's not fair to you guys. It's not fair to other people. But the main thing is I like all the comments from people that are cool. And I do all of that, but I should be replying to those instead. It's human nature to reply to the negativity. So what we're going to start doing is, you can disagree with what I'm saying. A lot of people do it. It's fine. If you disagree and you're coming ultra negative, like just you're going to get blocked. And I'm not even going to say nothing to you. It's going to be blocked, comment removed. That's it. We're not even going. So I'm giving you a warning right now. That's your warning. So if you want to come overly negative, over the top about this and that, and hey, blocked. Comment removed, disrespectful, not going to be tolerated. Hey, if you feel like you've been blocked in there, hit me up on Twitter, something like that. We'll review it, and now we'll go from there. But anyway, like I said, I've just been giving too much of my time to the negative people where I should be talking to all the positive people that love me in the comments, but that's just human nature. I'm flawed just like everybody else, and that's just what it is, man. I'm sorry about that. So if you want to talk to me, we're going to be extra active in the comments today. Holla at your boy, and, you know, do stuff like that. And also, make sure, let's get the video to 500 likes, man. We got to get the, y'all been slacking on the likes lately, baby. We need to get the 500 likes. So let's just get it going, man. First things first, what are we going with today? The Tesla Cybertruck or the all-new 2020 Ford F-150? Ooh, that thing fire. Boy, look at them rib tie. Boy, you know I'm from the country. You know my black. You know I'm from the country. You know I'm country as hell, bye. The all-new Tesla Cybertruck, I'm not going to lie, it does look nice. It's going to be about $63,000 base model, probably $80,000. I don't know, it's going to be like 30-some-odd thousand base model, and then it's going to get up to like $60,000. They have gotten the price down on these Teslas a lot. So, you know, it's going to be competitive. I think it says like $39,000. You can pre-order it now. You just put $100 down. I ain't rich. I'm not got that. I don't got that YouTube money like that. You know what I'm saying? I don't make like, you know, 20, 30 grand like everybody else. You know, I make about two. That's all I make. But hey, $2,000 from putting up these weak ass videos, something else, man. It is what it is. Or the all new Ford F-150, boy. That thing fire. Now look, I'm just gonna go back and forth between these real quick, man, just because of the fact that I do like the Cybertruck, but I like the F-150. It's just, you know, it's old, it's the elegant appeal. And then it's just the new versus the old school. If I could afford this, I would probably get one. But I feel like this kind of makes you a target. And people are like, you know what? I'm going to follow him home and try to rob this. Yo, Calvin got a new job. Let's rob this kid, yo. So I feel like only if you can live in a gated community and you live in the upper echelon should you be driving this. But, you know, I can't be pulling into my subdivision with this. People going to think I got money and they're going to be wrong as hell. They're going to rob me and they're just going to be practicing. So, you know, it is what it is. But this Ford F-150, I feel like you can drive that anywhere all over the world. That's my only thing about it. I would definitely drive this Tesla Cybertruck, and I would definitely buy one. But, you know, it's just like, I just feel like, but I mean, they say it's bulletproof. You can't break into it. The windows, you can throw stuff at. The production model, you won't be able to really break the windows. They said this is this stuff is called clear metal or glass metal glass or something like that. So you're not supposed to be able to break it. He hit it with a hammer. You can't really hurt it. So you can't do too much to it. But you know, I'm thinking they might try to break into my house. I do got the unbreakable windows on my house. But you know it is what it is, man. Anyway, we didn't talk too long about this stuff, man. On to what's important. The Winter Madness schedule is here. From December 20th to December 31st, we got the Winter Madness. The only thing that sticks out to me, it ain't no Puma Mania. I say it ain't no Puma Mania. But you know, the 20th, we got Rush. 21st, we got 3v3, and we got 3v3 Rush. You know, you got the 1v1 rush on the 22nd. You got the 4-on-4 and the 5-on-5. I guess that's going to be in the park. Was it double rep 4-on-4, 5-on-5? Or is that going? Does that mean 5-on-5? Does that mean? No. That means it's going to be a 5-on-5 court out there. That's going to be kind of dope. I can see that. You got gold rush. I'm sitting in front of the gold rush. Let me move myself real quick. You got gold rush. You're going to have cages. Going to have double rep. I guess you're going to have rodeo dodgeball, so the park's going to be laggy as hell. Then you got double rep in the rec. So I guess the 3v3 and the 5-on-5 is going to be something different. Can they leave the 4v4 courts over there? I mean, would y'all like, y'all let me know if y'all would like for them to leave the 4v4 courts, like over there where the Iverson wall is and stuff like that. We got our Formula One, Treasure Hunters, Big Top is coming back. You got Beats, so you can get your backpack and a sleeve in this. Court Conqueror coming back 2-on-2, 3-on-3. You got Boot Camp coming back. Please govern yourself accordingly so you don't get banned. Basketball Gods. You got Dime Time. And then we got Dunk Fest coming back. All these things are coming back. And this is the Winter Madness schedule. On the 30th, bro, they should just slide some Puma Mania in there is what I feel like. Like, why not just slide that Puma Mania in there? I feel like we need some Puma Mania, man. Like, I don't feel like the game is dry. I don't feel like the game is dying or anything like that. But and I really think that this is one of the better 2Ks in a while. This is just my opinion. Hey, feel free to disagree. If you disagree, you can let me know down in the comments. I don't think it's the best, respectfully. You know what? I don't think this is the best 2K. But I think this is one of the best 2Ks in a while. I've been working on my center. My center dope. He ready. I was playing with my guy Big Mix last night. We got some good gameplay. But at toward the end, my boost wore off and I couldn't shoot anymore. But I went back, tweaked my jump shot, came back, played with T-Mizzle. Boy, I was out there cashing, boy. Me and Big Paul, so we out here. We out here, man. Anyway, up next, the emails have gone out. Emails have gone out to 175 players who participated in the combine and are moving on to the interview stage. Those who have not advanced have also been notified. So the emails went out either way, and with the emails having gone out, you already know that, hey, tons of people from Hawks Talent Game. I'm looking at Coach from Hawks Talent Game. If you're not following him, you need to follow him. Hey, look, we got a female that got one. Wendy Fleming. Hey, look. Well, let me see what she said. Inaugural season, top 250 women's combine champ. Hey, you gotta love that, man. Hey, Oakland Rose got through. Vonnie the Goat got through. A lot of these people got through. If you want to see a lot more of these people that got through, man, you go. Akilla Cam got through. Hoodie Kobe got through. If you want to see a lot of these people that got through, man, go hit up Coach's Twitter, and you will be able to check that out. It's going to be dope. Hey, salute to everybody that actually made the league. And, man, Godspeed to y'all, man. Hope y'all make it to the top, whatever it is, whether it's top 105 or something like that, I think it is. Hope y'all make it. And I wish nothing but good things for you. And I don't understand, like, why can I wish people luck? But you got people in the YouTube comments that are cyber keyboard warriors with awful lives that just want to hate on stuff. Y'all do know, like when people hate on me in the comments, all I do is search YouTube and I look at all of your comments. And when I see all of your comments, I'm like, bro, are you serious? Like, some of the stuff that people be commenting, man, it's revealing. Like, a dude in the comments was hating on me yesterday, and I went and searched his comments across YouTube, and on another video, he was like, Jason Statham will always be Handsome Rob. What? Bruh, okay, anyway, man, like I said, up next, man, I ain't gonna expose nobody. It ain't no point in it. Look, last but not least, the NBA 2K18 servers may be shutting down. They may not be. I don't know. But it says, I'm Davis just tweeted out. Every year, 2K tweets out about the old 2K shutting down, except for this year. There's no way that 18 is the first game that's staying up, right? That he wanted to say staying up. Okay, and then he put up the tweets. He searched the tweets and he's like, look, on December 5th, 2017, they said the NBA 2K servers will be discontinued at the end of the year. Boom. On the 30th of November 2018. Oh, that was 2018. Yeah, 2017. On the 30th of November 2018, they said at the end of the year, NBA 2K17 servers will be gone. Players will no longer be able to rank games online or, you know, association, whatever. This year, he went through and searched, and all you see is maintenance. So, Are the NBA 2K18 servers staying up? I got a theory about it, man. If they are staying up, it must mean that the neighborhoods are all linked together. And, you know, the whole concept of the neighborhood, it's either one or two things. If it's staying up, it's because the concept of the neighborhood, they're linked together and they're on the servers and they're just building off of one and onto the next. As far as the neighborhood, which would make more sense if it was 2K19 and 20, where they wouldn't shut down 19 because they couldn't shut down 19 without shutting down 20. But I don't know if that's the case. Either way, I'll tell you this. Oh, yeah, Jim Star shirt will be in the store today. I promised y'all. It's going to be end of the day. I got y'all. I know y'all want this. I know y'all need it. I got you. And, hey, but look, though, this is the thing, right? With the NBA 2K18 service, that's the first model for the continued monetization of the game. We don't know what the population of NBA 2K18 is, but if it's still pretty high, I can assure you that they're still selling ads over there. And if they're selling ads and they're making money off the game, you know, off the population of the game, they're still selling ads, they still got people playing and stuff like that. I think maybe I need to go back to 2K18 and see if anybody's still playing or anything like that. But if the parks are, if there's any population on the game at all, I wish I could see what the game population was, but if there's any population, they're making money off of the neighborhood because of the ads. That was the first, as we reported on that a lot in 18, that was the first walking, talking advertisement where they could change the ads on the billboards at will, and they could do all that stuff, man. So we'll see how that works out. What do you guys think? You think they're going to keep it up or you think they're going to get rid of it? I don't know. But anyway, what you need to tell me about is Tesla Cybertruck or the new Ford F-150. I say the Tesla Cybertruck or the new Ford F-150, man. I don't know. Y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comments. If you like the video, like the video. Make sure you like the video and subscribe for more daily 2K content, man. If you made the NBA 2K League, let me know down below. And I'm hollering at y'all next time. Till next time. It's your boy Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed. Damn right it's under 12 minutes. That's right. I said that's right. Hi.